a hill. Come on in the room. What up? Hey y'all, what's up? What's up? What's up? Baby, it's slow out here. Hey, so all the people that's coming on in, I want you to tap the screen. What's up? Y'all wanted it. Here I am. I want y'all to tap the screen. Tap the screen. Let's get them likes up. Share the live. Let's get it. Let's go. What's up? What's up? What's up? Hey, friend. Hey, friend. Hey, y'all. I said I'm going to give me a background and show, like, the whole experience. You can show, see that cap up under there, right there. What's up? If this is your first time in my live, just let me know so I can introduce myself properly. I am Coach Misty. Okay? And you are here for Spiritually Ratchet readings. Yes, I do order, Lord. Thank you. I do answer yes or no questions. Do not try to yes or no me. I do give you more detail. I can answer a question, pass yes or no, or give you an explanation for a donation. I'm going to go ahead. Just tell me to raise my hand. Whenever y'all need my hand, need my information. Thank you, friend. Say she the real deal. That's the information, okay? So we do Cash App questions. I'm going to say this probably every 10 minutes. Y'all going to get sick of me tonight. I will never contact you on TikTok. Okay? So I would never contact you on TikTok. If you're ever contacted on TikTok or Instagram by an account that look like me, baby, it is not me. Period. It ain't me. I don't do all that. Okay? I do not pimp my gift like that. So, y'all got to catch me on live. And as I said, you say, well, I need to leave my current job because of new management. Yes, you will. Because the old management is going to put a bad taste in your mouth. Okay? So, I do have live readings online. Huh? Yes. Yes. Listen, will I hear from a job at Blood One next week? Yes. Will the school year be better for my daughter? Yes. Hey, friend. I will do live readings tonight. Will Joshua approach me? No. First of all, dream roles. Okay, let me say this and say that. This probably going to be like any other doggone reading you have ever had in your life. Why? Because I am what? Spiritually ratchet. I got on one earring and not the other, okay? I got on somebody else's hair. I keep it 100 with you. I don't have no cards. I don't have no rods. I don't have no where you been. Free and minding my fat business. Minding my fat business. Trying to see how I'm going to hide this cap. You can see the cap right there. I don't care. Will I receive some of my dad's checking account money? I don't like the way that sound, okay? So, yeah. If this your first time here, welcome to Spiritually Ratchet. This is how we do this. Huh? You can get a reading like this. You can go on my link tree. Make sure you take a screenshot. What up, Cedric? You can go on my link tree. I only do yes or no's. They say whoever hasn't gotten a reading from Misty, I totally recommend it. Life-changing, she be knowing. Thank you, friend. So we have multiple people in the comments that who have gotten readings from me. If you want to ask a question, you can ask them. I don't think none of my moderators are here yet. What's up, B-Hawk 50 Trees? I don't think none of my moderators are here yet. But, yeah, there we go. Thank you for the follow, baby. So you can cash app. My readings are 10 minutes for $25, not $10. I am not those girls. I am not those girls. You hear me? I am not going to give you no roundabout BS reading talking about when the moon aligned with the stars and the planets and Jupiter rising. I don't know none of that. I don't give a damn about your birthday. I don't care about your sign. Do not talk about, and I'm a Taurus woman with a Capricorn man. Well, I'm fat and my ex is skinny. What does that mean? Am I going to get a young boy feature? You actually are. Will I start dating again soon? Yes. So here's the deal. If you want a pregnancy one, you'd have to do a Cash App donation for a pregnancy question, or you can do a reading. Okay, will my car ever get fixed right? No, you just need to just trade it in and get something else, sis. Is Bernard the one for me? Oh, he is. New job for you. Yes. Friends about she be knowing. So y'all hashtag. If you ask me something in this live and I call it out, you better hashtag I be knowing or she be knowing. You hear? Well, Jack and I try again. You will, but it ain't gonna work. You want a house. Well, okay. That was a statement. I believe in manifestation to the fullest. You can have anything you want to have. What's up with this Leo? Girl, that is not a yes or no question. That's not a yes or no question. Should I look for a new job in cybersecurity? Yes. Will I get the position? No. Will I get married again? Yes. But it's not going to be the last marriage. Girl, tell me would IRS go away. Not for you, they won't. Hashtag, she be knowing. All right, y'all. Is Mike going to propose? Oh, friend, fuck no. All right, y'all. Is Antoine confused? Confused about whether he like you? No, he just don't like you. Hey, friend, what else? Will David be home this month? No, not yet. Will I get an ankle monitor off in September? Stop committing crime. Will Joel and I ever become in a relationship? No. Okay. Will I find love again? Yes, you will. Will I find true love? Okay, you know what? Let me tell you another thing. Y'all be getting on here asking me thirsty questions about these big head men. So if my thirst becomes too much, I pull out my Jesus juice. I'm getting thirsty already and we just got started. We just got started. I don't mind y'all asking me questions about these dudes, but do not be mad at me when I have to drink something. Okay, friend, talking about it's been 2 years since I got in trouble because you're on house arrest. Okay, this is nothing but Skittle water, but I prayed over it. My Jesus juice is nothing but Skittle water, but I prayed over it. So now it is Jesus juice. Should I leave my husband? Absolutely. Girl, this ain't nothing but Skittle packets, but I pray over it. I anointed my Skittle packets. Listen, I'm going to say this. Do not ask me to do no damn spells. The only time I deal with eggs is when I'm eating them scrambled. That's not my deal. I got somebody for you if you want that. I don't do that, okay? You said, I've been in house arrest for 8 months. You so funny. No, friend, you so funny because you's a criminal. But call me because I'm pretty sure you could do something with my credit. Will Tunde ask me to marry him? Yes. What did the Jesus do? The Jesus juice. So here's the deal. Well, y'all get on here asking me about Deshaun, Lil Ron, Joel, Larry, all these real stupid names, David. You get on here, y'all dating dudes with names that's not even faithful. Like, you ain't never made a faithful Sean in your life. So here's the deal. I really get thirsty. So let me tell y'all about what I do for some of y'all new hoes that's on here, okay? I get, like, when y'all ask me thirsty questions, it makes me get thirsty. I am a super empath, okay? I am a super empath. So when y'all start getting thirsty, it makes me thirsty. When y'all are sad, it makes me sad. You see what I'm saying? So I just want to let y'all know, sometimes I have to drink the Jesus juice because I am parched. Because it just be so much thirstiness coming. And it's okay for you to be in thirsty because you want to know. And I'm cool with that. But I'm just saying, give me a minute to refresh myself because I'm picking up on your thirsty spirit. Okay? Thirsty. You say, where you been? We missed you. A friend, I've been minding my fat business. You know, sometimes you got to do that. Y'all make sure. Let's tap the screen. Likes are free. Tap the screen. Will I ever get on track? Monique, what's stopping you from getting on track? Will God send a man truly for me? Yes, Miss Red, but I need you to take the blinders off. You know what I'm saying? There's been some men that's been for you, but they didn't have certain criteria. See, Miss Red, I'm going to read you just because I want to read you. Okay? Listen. Miss Red, you got a whole list. Now tell me I'm lying. Listen, you got a whole list, Miss Red, of what this man's supposed to have. And it's been men that you done met that certain things they did not have. How do you get a reading? This is how you get a reading. You can cash app $25 with your phone number, or you can go on my link tree and book it. Huh? You've missed out on 3 opportunities because this man didn't have a certain something. And I ain't talking about a leg or a tooth or something like that. But he didn't have a certain something. I need you to stop that, Miss Red. You hear me? I need you to stop that. Yeah, I'm back. Damn, I have to spend time with my kid. And y'all, sometimes do I need to leave Jefferson? Baby, I don't know if Jefferson is a man or a county, but both of them is a yes. Will I get a new job offer? Not right now, you won't. Will I get engaged this year? No, friend, you will not. You say, will my business be successful? Yes. Will I quit my overnight job this year? Yes. Will I get the role I auditioned for in December or January? Yes, you will. Okay. So, y'all, I also do questions. Thank you. Y'all, I forgot to put that shit up. Hey, if y'all want information on where I get my hair from or whatever, go ahead and just, you see that number? You can text hair if you want information about, you fine, friend. If you want information about my workout program, and yes, I do work out. I've trained over 1,000 women. I'm fat because Lizzo is fat. And as long as Lizzo is fat and selling y'all shapewear, I'm going to be fat and selling you a workout. When Lizzo drop weight, then I'm going to drop weight. I tell y'all that all the time. Will Gerard and I get back together? First of all, I don't even like the way he spelled his name. I don't know if that was Gerard or Gerald. I need you to let that go. Okay? Will my nonprofit and podcast be successful? Yes. It will. Okay, so here's the deal about the manifestation class. Some of you whores missed the class this Sunday. Last Sunday. I'm not doing the manifestation class this Sunday coming up. Okay? I'm not doing that. You want to work. So here's the deal. You can text that number and say workout and reading, and I will send you both links. Or you can just go to my link tree. Go to my link tree. You say, well, when you dropped in pounds, tell me where I need that. Hold on, friend, because I used to be bigger than I was. Now, I don't know if you're coming for me or trying me, but I'm about to read you your rights. First of all, I used to be bigger than I was. And just because I'm this size, don't mean I will not outwork your ass. You hear me? I have people who walk up to me every day in a damn gym and be like, I dudes to be like, man, you out here putting it in. Don't play with me. Now, I keep the girl snatched. If you want receipts, I got receipts. If you want receipts, I got receipts. I keep the girl snatched. Because from the calculations I did yesterday, when I was pulling a 200-pound sled and pushing it, I probably can pick you up and throw you. Hello. Get into it. Now, we back on the spiritually. You say, right. Don't play with me as I drink my Skittle water. Oh, baby, my eyebrows are microbladed. They've been like this for about 2 years, 2.5 years. You said you skinny trying to gain? Come on, friend. Well, come on. Come on. I got you. Hold on. Hey, Misty. Got my mother watching me with me tonight. She found her a man. Both of y'all need a damn man. Y'all need to go to the damn dating thing together. It's okay, Phoenix. You fine. We good. You ain't got to keep apologizing. We fine. But I help people gain weight, too. So I am a certified personal trainer and a nutritionist and a certified Zumba teacher. So if you do need some help, y'all, it's okay. If they do need some help or whatever, then, you know, that's that. So the question about Michael, I'm not going to answer that question on here because that could be a life or death question, okay? So if you want, here's the deal. If you want information about the hair, the workout, the readings, all you got to do is text that number and tell me what you need. Thank you so much. Will I get a better position at work? Yes. You said, would this be a good financial year for me? I need y'all to make that decision. Will I remarry? No. Does Dodd say, you met someone? Okay, I'm going to say, both y'all need a damn man. But if you met someone, friend, I want you to see where that goes. But yes, your mama will find a man. All right, y'all. So let me see. We might have some Cash App questions. Let's check for Cash App questions first. Y'all hoes not going one and two me to death. Or do we? All right, Leslie. Leslie, I need your phone number, Bookie. Leslie, if you still watching this, I need you to text me. I need you to text me your phone number, okay? Leslie, I need your phone number. If you want a live reading right now on the tick of a tock, you can go ahead and Cash App your phone number, $25, and I will call you right now and give you your reading live. And you could ask me anything. You looking forward to my class? Okay. Will I get the counselor job soon? Yes. All right. Will I make it to Cali this summer? You actually will. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. If you want information about where I got this hair, just text the word hair to that number and I'll give you that. We got a code that you can get free shipping on your hair as well. Girl, I said, didn't I ask him this question, Brittany 124? You know, let me say this to say that. Hold on. Let me say this and say that. See, y'all know, I'm going to say this. I'm going to let y'all get one free yes or no question. One free yes or no question. That's it. Y'all not gonna sit up here and yes or no me. I am not these girls. I am not these girls on here to just be like, yeah, and then like, so you can know. I'm not them. And the people who've had readings from me understand, well, then you need to go ahead and just go ahead and you can go to my link tree and do a thing. I am not, so who is Leslie? Leslie needs to text me her number. Leslie needs to text me her number. If you want a live reading, you can go ahead and do $25 for 10 minutes to the Cash App and include your number. Question, baby. Y'all need to be careful about who you reach out to for spiritual guidance. Okay? Y'all need to be careful about who you reaching out to for spiritual guidance. Friend said, everything you told me, I believe in. It's been coming true. Good job. I don't answer life and death questions on here. You got to use my Cash App number. That's what you do. Use the Cash App number. Take a screenshot. Use the phone number. So y'all Cash App me by phone number, because there's a lot of scammers who have made Cash Apps that look like my Cash App and do it. Love B, she said bye. Okay, friend. Well, we can go ahead and we can do that. I ain't about to play with these hoes. Will I start the text drop this year? Yes, ma'am. So baby, the one that asked me about you losing a baby, that'd be a question. You'd have to do that via Cash App. I'm not going to answer that on there. Well, I don't like answering baby questions, because that'd be deep. And, you know, sometimes I know y'all like, okay, she being a little rah, rah, rah. Friend, the pay will be over $40,000. Now, you keep messing with me, I'm going to make sure it's only $41,000. Okay? Stop. You asked that question 36 times. The pay will be over $40,000, okay? All right. Who on a reading? I'm not about to play with you. I can go to the movies tonight. I can go to the movies and we can do this again tomorrow. All right. So here we go. Lori Jones, you up. So I got two ladies that cashed at me but did not send me their number. Can y'all text me your number, please? Text me your number, please, okay? So the people who cashed at me for the reading who did not do it. You say my screen froze? So for the people who cashed at me and did not put their phone number in the memo, please text me and send me your phone number. Say, hey, this is my phone number with my Cash App. Y'all let me know if my screen, okay. All right, some of y'all need to get the beggar signal in your house and switch from AT&T to Spectrum. All right, but in the meantime, between time, we got Lori Jones. When is my workers' comp case going to be settled? Lori, your workers' comp case is going to be settled late September. Okay, so late September is when they're going to settle your workers' comp case. Make sure you're taking a lot of notes when you go to your doctor's visits and all that stuff, because your job is going to try to pull a fast one. But it will be late September when your workers' comp case is settled. And, you know, when you get that little coin, you know, send me $2, friend. I'm just playing. But, yeah, honey, it's going to be late September. And make sure you keep all your notes. All right, so let's go ahead and go to I see somebody sent me a thing and said, hey, I was the one that cashed at you. So here we go. We about to do one. They are shady. I know, friend. They trying you. I be knowing. That's why I say keep your notes. All right, Chanel, here you go, Chanel. I'm going to have to contact the other lady. All right, you want reading and workout information. Okay, I'm going to send you the workout information as well. Y'all, I'm actually while we calling Chanel, I'm having a Find Your Box challenge. A FUPA challenge.
Hello.
Hey, friend, it's Misty.
How you doing today?
I'm good. This is your first time watching me on live?
Yeah.
Okay, I know. I be knowing. All right, so here's the deal. You can ask me anything you want while you pay for a reading. The only thing I ask is that your questions be clear and direct. All right, so what you want to talk about first?
I am looking to start an online business, and I just want to know, will it be up and running by the end of this year or by the end of next year? And will I be successful in it?
Okay, so your online business should be up and running before Thanksgiving so you can do something on Black Friday. What is stopping you? Why? So this is what I'm getting. It, the only reason why this business is not up and running is because you feel like you haven't done enough research or something. Like, why are you holding back from opening up this business?
I have a habit of getting in my own way.
Boom, because I be knowing.
Yeah,
I knew that was because of you.
Of getting in my own way. Everyone else believes in me and they see my vision and I see it, but I guess I'm more in fear of failure.
I need you to stop. This business should have been up and running. For you to even come on here and say at the end of next year, there's no reason. There's no financial reason. There's no logistics reason. The only reason is you. And I need you to make a decision. Let me tell you what I need you to do. I need you to dedicate the next 10, if you even, I don't know if you got 10 weekends. We should have at least the next 10 weekends into building this business, okay? Because I don't want you to work on it during the week because you will get into your own mind and you'll go off into a spiral and start thinking of something else and just going deeper than what it needs to go. Your business plan is ready to go. Everything is ready to go and you know how to get all of your site, all that stuff up and running. I need this business up and you're going to actually launch on Black Friday. Friend, if you do what I'm telling you to do, by next year you can quit your job.
Okay.
A year from then, you'll be able to quit your job. I need you to come on with it. I knew you were standing in your own way. I felt it in my spirit.
Yeah, I know. I'm getting in my own way. I get to overthinking things at times.
I know. What else you want to talk about?
Okay. I've had some tremendously horrible relationships in the past. I have had a relationship in the last year and a half with someone who is 14 years younger than myself. And for the first time in about 7 years, I actually feel an emotional tie to someone. And I'm getting in my own way again. I don't know if I'm in fear and I'm just ready to run.
So let me say this. Let me tell you what I'm picking up on. I'm not picking up on your feelings. I'm picking up on his. You really wearing this man down with this foolishness. And he's starting to become numb. If you want to keep this situation going, I need you to chill out.
Okay.
For real.
I mean, he's told me because, I've put on weight and he's like, okay. You know, and I'm older than him. And he's like, okay, you know, like, why do you keep bringing up stuff I already know?
I just told you starting to wear him out. I know it. I feel it. Like, he's really, listen, I don't feel nothing like in a way like, oh, this is not for you or nothing like that. And I'm not picking up on yours. It's his. And he's really starting to kind of get tired of it. And I need you to go ahead and chill out. The only person that's insecure about your age, the age difference is you. The only person that's insecure about your weight is you. He will love you no matter what. I need you to chill out.
Okay.
You're going to push him into the arm. See, let me tell you something. The last two of them left you for somebody else. It wasn't like, oh, we broke up and then now. No, they left you for... And what you're really doing is you don't want that to happen, so you're trying to control this situation. But your insecurities are controlling the situation. And then when he do what the other ones did, then you can be like, well, I knew that was going to happen anyway, and he was just like the rest. This is also about your fear of failing. You don't want to believe that maybe he is different. It's easier to believe that he's like the other one than to believe that he is right. Now, people want to know how old he is. Y'all mind your business. He's 18 and a half.
Well, I've been celibate for the last 3 years.
That's your problem. That's what's wrong with you. You need to get you some.
I plan on.
Wait a minute. You ain't gay this man none? And he's still around?
Yes.
Girl, if you don't propose to him, is you crazy?
Propose to him?
You need to propose to him. You need to propose to him. He done stuck around. Okay? You out here eating bun buns. Jesus Christ. Speaking of bun buns, hold on, y'all. I had me some ice cream. my damn self. Hold on, let me eat my ice cream bar. You out here eating bun buns, huh? Hello?
I'm here.
and you out here ain't giving this man none. You working his nerves, huh? And he said, okay. Oh, my God. I don't know what mega church you go to, honey, but prayer is real. If you don't sit down somewhere.
Yeah, and for the ones who actually want to know how old he is, he's 31 and I'm 45.
That ain't nothing wrong with that. 31 and 45. That man could be out here doing several. I'm going to eat a thing for you. You done stressed me out. Okay? I wasn't supposed to eat this till the last thing I was going to eat tonight. You done stressed me out. I'm sitting within my 10-hour eating window for intermittent fasting.
You know, sometimes it's better to hear it from somebody else because I'm so lasered in on failure and things not, you know, going the way that I want them to go. That sometimes I need that outside influence.
No, I'm telling you right now. I don't know what you're holding on to that thing for, but you need to give it up. Okay?
Okay.
Today. Okay. Right now. I don't know what you holding on for. To what?
See, okay. Can I be a little graphic with you?
Please, do. Okay. We want to know.
I'm a highly sexual person. And when I say I'm a highly sexual person, I'm bisexual and I'm polyamorous. So I have a tendency to get crazy people who don't want to let go and be doing the most at times. And sometimes I feel like it's my sexuality that drives people crazy. So I kind of didn't want to engage with that with him. You know, I feel like we've had a stable relationship where sex haven't been involved.
Girl, y'all had a stable friendship.
Other ways to be intimate.
Baby, the lights went out on our ass. You had a stable friendship. That's a pen pal. That's a lion leap. What? What? We had a stable relationship because you ain't did nothing. You up here and then you got the nerve to be not only. I thought you was a little stiff at first. Now you're talking about I'm polyamorous. You didn't all listen. You talking about I'm polyamorous. What color do you even use? What flag color is this?
Thing though, like, I've had family members who tell me, like, you drive men nuts, so you gotta be careful with that thing, it's a little dangerous. So I kind of keep my cookie in the jar until I figure out whether or not they sane enough to handle whatever I'm putting on their plate.
Man, how long you been with this man?
A year and a half.
A year and a half? And you ain't gave him none? Baby, he the one that's... Girl, look. I'm sorry to say that. Both y'all nuts, okay? Both y'all crazy as hell. You got the nerve to love everything. Baby, you out here dating inanimate objects. You dating multiple people. You dating paperclip. Okay. And then you got the nerve not to get this man enough for a year and a half.
I mean, one, I needed to make sure by him being younger that he was serious. You know, like not just this a fetish thing, you know, he just trying something out. I needed to know he was serious about.
Man, propose that man tonight. Propose that man tonight. Propose that man tonight. That man 31, you done wasted a year and a half of his life. If you don't get your Thundercat ass up. Yeah. What is wrong with you?
Well, I mean, I get it. You're right.
And you owe me another Häagen-Dazs bar. I wasn't supposed to eat this till I wasn't supposed to eat this. I still had an hour and a half.
Oh, well, I mean, I appreciate you.
No. What else you want to know?
Two biggest things in life right now. And right now, my whole life is absolutely wonderful. My two biggest stresses have been
sex,
and moving on moving forward in this relationship?
Listen, if you don't go here, where that man at right now? Right now, Lord. Oh, Lord, we're going to drop some on the desk. Where he at?
He not here right now. He'll be here later.
Look, give him some today. Got to be more careful. What else? You got one more question. Crazy. Tell.
On the way. I just need to know if
he's
gonna be healthy.
Yeah, he's gonna be healthy. And baby, he's gonna be dancing just like you when he's about 20. Okay? That boy ain't gonna far from the tree.
His father is about as bad as I am.
Well, his grandson gonna pick up on your spirit.
Okay.
Girl, you done made me get some of my hair. Oh my God. Good night, Thundercat. Go on and stop. No, for real. Get this man what he wants today. Stop playing around.
Okay.
Good night.
Forget to give me the other information.
What other information?
For the exercise.
Oh, yeah, okay. I'm going to send it to you right now. Look at me. I'm going to send it to you right now, friend. Y'all give it up for Thundercat. No, she lying. Up here talking about somebody told me not to do it. Girl, whoever told you it was dangerous, they ain't getting none. Get off my damn phone. 3 years, celibate. This man been around for 18 months. I would have left you in 18 minutes. Yeah, they said, come back and tell us what happened. That call on me. Look, that call for free.
Okay.
I'll be back tomorrow night. Call us. Just text me and say you want to go live, and we'll call you, okay?
Okay.
Y'all give it up for Thundercat. Yes, that was her first reading. Spiritually ratchet. Woo! Congratulations, Nasty Tail. I'm hanging up. All right, y'all. That was a good one. Hey, give it up for her. She was a newbie. She's talking about, how you know my nickname is Thundercat? Crazy tail. All right, y'all. Who next? All right. So, Chanel. Chanel has, let me see. Chanel sent a Cash App donation. Will my success will be business? Will my business be successful next year? Yes, Chanel. Your business is actually going to take off right after Valentine's Day, okay? You said you told me my ex-husband will come around after the second grandbaby. Now he my sneaky link. You welcome. But Chanel, if you on here, yes, your business is going to be successful, baby. It's going to go to new heights right after Valentine's Day. So I want you to make sure you are ready. Okay. Friends say, well, God sent me the husband he wants for me. Do you know the husband you want for you? Y'all give it up for Chanel. That was a good one. Do you know the husband you want for you? Y'all leave Leslie. I'm going to send you a thing because you didn't send me your number. All right. Who want another free reading? Oh, wait. I didn't say that shit. I didn't say a free reading. Who wants another live reading? Yikes. Who wants another live reading? Whoa. Should I call him or wait? Call him. Will I relocate soon? Yes. Will my divorce be finalized this year? Yes. I ain't say no free reading. I know that shit jumped out my body. Where are one of my old heads at? I might give one of my old heads a free reading. This is somebody, y'all see that's somebody who's been rocking with me for a minute. All right, we're going to do it like this. I'm thinking of a number between 1 and 10. Shut y'all asses up. Somebody look at God. I'm here. Shay's abundance. Hold on. Shay, you in the damn thing. Professional KM. You got a free reading. It's a 5-minute one, though. Give me a call. Professional KM, you got one. Give me a call. It's a 5-minute one. Call me. I'll pick two more to get a 5-minute one. So I'm talking about people who didn't had it. Friends say five. People who didn't had. Oh, fuck no. No, Kenosha, do not call me. You are not getting a reading. Do not call my phone, Kenosha. No, hell nah. No. Kenosha, I don't have time for that today. No. Kenosha calling my goddamn phone. I'm not... Kenosha... Wait a second. Kenosha, I just said do not call me. You is not about to stress my ass out tonight. Just as I am 77, you got a free reading. Just as I am 77, you got a free reading. Kenosha is not going to get a reading because Kenosha makes my baby hair grow up. So just as I am... call me just as I am. Give me a call. You got one. I'm going to give you a 5-minute reading.
Right now.
Huh?
I'm here.
You hear what?
I'm
Hold on, I'm getting too much feedback. Kenosha, I call you back. I'm not about to play with Kenosha. Just as I am, give me a call. Just as I am, give me a call. You got a free 5-minute reading. I think I'm going to bless some. I think I'm going to bless some of y'all tonight. How about that? Free 5-minute reading, just as I am. All right, here we go. Hey, friend.
Hey, best friend.
What's hey. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, go. What you want to know?
I am getting ready to start a business. I live in Atlanta, and it's something that, you know, when happen in Atlanta, they happen. And I want to know what's it going to be like.
Be like as far as, what do you mean?
Is it going to be successful?
You start a new business in Atlanta?
Yes.
Why?
Because I live here and I love it here.
Okay. You ain't never thought about like going over. So if you start the business in Atlanta, it's not going to do too much. You actually need to start that business in North Carolina somewhere.
Oh, no. Uh-uh.
Okay. All right, well, what else you want to know? You go in Atlanta, you're going to break even.
In Atlanta, I'm going to break even?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I
going
to have fun doing what I'm going to do?
You always going to have fun doing what you want to do, but you're going to break even.
Okay.
All right, what about your love life?
Yeah, tell me about it.
You're going to have to go outside of Atlanta and find someone. I know that demand much. You don't want none in the, listen, you don't want none in Atlanta.
To retire.
You don't want none in Atlanta. Because you don't even know what you're getting in Atlanta.
Yeah, I know.
Definitely. So, no, but okay, here's the deal. So let me go ahead and give you some words of comfort. You are going to meet you're going to meet somebody who's a little more seasoned. He's going to be out of Warner Robins. Okay?
Uh-huh.
He is going to work either with the city or he has like on a uniform. He either works for the city or like the trash or something like that. But he's going to be like a blue collar worker. He has been divorced for about 5 to 7 years. And he's actually going to take you out, like outside of Atlanta and, you know, teach you about the country.
Teach me about the country.
Yes, like how they get down in his area. You're going to have a good time. You're going to end up meeting this man in about 3 months.
All right.
All right. What else?
Any money coming?
Do I see any money coming other than the money you get from retirement? No. I don't see any other, like no big lump sums of money or anything like that, but you are okay.
Yes, I
am. I know you okay. You ain't sitting up here hard up. You just said no. You can keep on, you know, playing the lottery if you want to, buy you some scratch offs if that make you smile, but no. I mean, other than that, you're fine. Like I said, you go ahead and start your business. If that's what you want to do, that's fine. But it's just going to break even. But as long as you're having fun, have fun.
Okay.
All right. You got anything else?
I think that's
it. Okay, friend. Well, listen, get ready for this Warner Robins. He's going to sweep you off your feet. Okay?
All right.
Yes. All right, friend. Thank you so much. All right, y'all. Who next? I'm going to give away some. You're going to have 3 free questions. I'm going to do live readings. Y'all support me. LaDonna Grant. Come on, LaDonna. Come on, LaDonna. Call me, girl. Call me, LaDonna. Who the hell is this? Hello?
Leslie. I'm sorry, this is Leslie.
Who is Leslie?
Oh, I don't have a cash app.
It's all right, Leslie. I'm going to bless your game tonight. You got 3 questions. What's up?
Well, I get the job and move to North Carolina.
You will get the job, but it's going to be, you're going to live on the borderline of North and South Carolina.
Oh, my God.
What?
I didn't want to hear that.
Why?
Because I don't want to be in South Carolina.
I said on the borderline. Now, you can put your foot, hold on. Whoever this is, call me from this 229 number. I'll call you right back. Okay, but I mean, you can say whatever. You can say you live in North Carolina if you want to, but you're literally going to live on the border of North and South Carolina. What else?
Will the entire family come? That's in my household right now.
You have an older son or something? Whoever, like, it's another, like, it's one of the males are not going to come.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Okay.
And well, oh gosh, will I buy a house, or will it be a house or an apartment?
No, it's gonna be a house.
Oh gosh, just put me back. I know where I'm going.
You know where you're going?
I think so.
Okay. All right. You can get one more other question. And whoever called me from the 229 number, I'll call you. You got one more question, friend.
Where I move to, will it be where my dad lives?
Yeah, really close.
Okay.
Okay. And that's why you need to be there.
Okay. Thank you very much. I appreciate
you're
it.
You're welcome. No problem. All right. Bye. Y'all give it up for her. Yes, she said, you ain't picked me. Don't matter if you picked me or not. I'm calling your ass anyway. Let me find out y'all deboing me like that. That's what I'm going to do tonight. Yes. Okay, so let's go ahead and call. Let's go ahead. LaDonna, I'm about to call you back. All right? LaDonna like, uh-uh, that was me, sis. What up, friend?
Hey, friend.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
Hold on. Friend said, you told me my daughter will have a baby next year. I found out Saturday she's pregnant. You welcome, because what? I be knowing. LaDonna, what you want to know?
Nothing much. Just got a lot on my mind.
Okay, well, come on. What's up?
I just want to know, is me and my kids, are we going to be okay, and is everything going to work out for us?
Didn't I answer this before for you?
I think so, girl.
I did. So my question is, stop, listen. Hey, listen. I want you to stop asking questions that you either I've answered before or that you've already. See, you need to walk, at this point, you need to walk in faith. So by you not doing that, not saying that you don't believe in me, because you ain't got to believe nothing I say, because you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I'm just going to keep my fat business. But I need you to believe it for you. You see what I'm saying? If you calling me and you ain't talked in a while. So if you calling and seeking those answers out, that means you don't believe that it's working out for you. That means you not changing your mindset. And that's a problem. I don't give a damn if you don't believe me or not. Okay? Because all I got to do is stay black and fat. Okay? And keep a wig on. However, I need you to believe it for you. Lord, let me light my sage up. And if this wig catch fire, LaDonna, that's your ass.
Oh, hell,
nah.
I love that wig, though.
Okay, friend, what else you want to know? Because I'm not even going to answer that because I already told you it was going to be all right, but I need you to believe it for your damn self.
I know it. What about my love life?
What love life? You need to get your shit together first. We talked about this, too. What love life?
Yeah.
Ooh. What love life?
I don't know.
A love life for what? You need to have love of yourself, the love of money. That's what your love life need to be. Not nobody. That's what your love need to be. My God. Stage this damn phone. What else?
Well, thank you, Missy.
Get off my phone, LaDonna, and get your mindset right. You need to be calling me for something totally other. Something totally different.
I know it.
Manifest this shit.
I know I want to move to Florida.
Okay, well, manifest that. You can move to Florida, friend.
Okay.
You're actually going to move a little bit. You're going to move outside of Miami, though.
Oh, okay.
Okay? I ain't say you was going to live in Miami. Pipe down. I said outside. Your ass going to be in Dade County somewhere, okay? Next to a Rick Ross ring stop. Get off my damn phone, LaDonna. We need to talk about changing your mindset. We'll have another conversation later. All right, y'all. Bye. Y'all give it up for LaDonna. LaDonna ain't about to worry me, her, or Kenosha. All right, y'all. I'm going to do one more free reading. One more free 5-minute reading. Ruby, you just had a reading with me. Should I call my new friend back tonight? Yes, ma'am. Have I met my next boyfriend? Yes, ma'am. Ashley, call me, baby. Call me. Ashley, give me a call. Call me. Satisfaction guaranteed. Call me, friend. So if y'all watching this and y'all want to book a private reading, you can go on my link tree and book a reading, or you can do $25 to my Cash App and put your phone number in the memo, please and thank you, and you will get your reading either Friday or Saturday. All right, you're on with Coach Misty. What's up?
Okay. Hi.
Hi, what you want to talk about? What you want to ask me, friend?
I want to know, I had a fight with my special friend, and I want to know if everything's going to be okay, because tonight he didn't say hi to me.
With your sneaky link?
Kind of, sort of,
yeah. Yeah, stop trying to put these words on it, because that ain't your man, my special friend. That's your sneaky link. And you want to know, what you want to know, if he going to come back over?
If we're going to turn in the water and just sneak.
No, you're not. You're not.
No.
No. No. So are you okay with just being a sneaky link?
No.
Okay, so what else you got?
Is he going to contact me again?
Yeah, when he want to get down with you. I'm going to say this to say that. I'm not saying this. I'm not trying to make you feel bad because I done had a sneaky link or two. Like late as last month, but I would just want you to be okay with the situation. I want you to know what you're dealing with, okay?
Yeah.
All right, and the reason why he really acting up with you is because he really needs some time to go explore some other sneaky link situation. So it was real convenient for y'all to get into it, and then he'd be like, you know, man, give me a minute or I'm mad or whatever, so he can go do whatever else he want to do.
Okay.
Not that he's committed to you or anything like that. I'm just letting you know. Okay.
Yeah.
What else you want to know?
Do I have a relationship coming with somebody else?
If you will let this go, first of all, this is what you need to do. You need to let this go, and you could have a relationship within the next year, but you need to do some work on yourself, okay? Because you're going up in another sneaky link situation. Why do you have an issue with telling people exactly what you want from the beginning? I know you're kind of young, and that may play a part in it, but you need to be able to say, I want a relationship, and not just hope that it turns into something.
Okay.
All right, so I need you to go ahead. Listen, I need you to go ahead and build up your confidence level. And it's not going to do that by being in these type of situations. So when you are ready to let go of the situation, then you need to just take some time to be by yourself. And just, you know, just build your confidence up. I'm not saying that you're not a bad B right now, but you have an issue with just telling people what it is. And this is more than just relationships with you. That's about other stuff, too. Am I lying?
No.
Okay, I know I ain't lying. Because I said what I said. Because I be knowing.
I'm trying to get better.
Right. Just get better with it and stop dealing with these sneaky links and all that stuff, okay? Because you do have a relationship coming next year. I'm talking about the type of relationship where y'all wearing matching clothes and taking pictures together and shit at the mall. That's the kind of thing you want. The relationship that somebody will claim you on social media. That's what you really want.
Yeah,
I know. You do. You want it and you deserve it. You better say it, friend. I want it and I'll have it. So go ahead and finish. You got to let this sneaky link, you got to let this situation run its course. Because if you try to cut him off dry, his ego is going to get attacked. And then he's going to just keep coming back. And it's not because he wants you back. It's because he want to be the one to say goodbye.
No, I sent him a text last night pretty much just telling him how I feel, like, that he can just say bye to me, and he didn't respond, and he didn't say anything tonight when you saw me at the field. So
okay, but that's okay, friend. So if you want to take that as your sign, and take it as your sign, but you deserve better. You hear me?
Mm-hmm.
And you, yes, you do. And I want you to start telling yourself that too. I'm for real. I'm talking about you, like when you look at yourself in the mirror, like, I'm a bad bee and I deserve better, and say exactly what it is you want. You hear me?
I do.
All right, friend. What else you want to know? That's it?
I think so, because I know, like, my career is fine. I feel like that's getting...
Okay.
I like my career. I like my house. I like everything else. I just, like, tired of being alone.
Friend, stop thinking of yourself as alone, honey. You're not alone. You just solo right now. Stop saying alone, okay? You solo right now. And ain't nothing wrong with rolling solo.
I know.
All right? You're going to be okay, friend. Virtual hugs. You're welcome. Yes. Give it up for her, honey bun. Yes. Katie, will my mom's situation get better? Yes. Ooh, Empress. You asked me about this love life one more time. Jesus Christ. Will my sister get her son money? Yes. What else? Yeah, that was a good one. All right, y'all. Y'all ain't about to free read my ass to death. I like the fact that I came on here, and even though I did not mean to say you're free reading, I like the fact that I'm doing it because I want to give back to y'all, okay? All right. Should I take an astrology course or a doula course? Do the doula. But But I'd be a successful nail tech. Friend, you don't know how to make an almond shape. Now cut it out. Cut it out. You need to take a class. Will I buy my house? Thank you so much, friend. Am I winning the lottery tonight? Girl, get off my goddamn thing. I love y'all too. Will I get a house? Twin cuts. Yeah, but it's going to be 2 years. Should I apply for this company with this simp? Yes. Will I get some D soon? Absolutely. Absolutely. What else, y'all? So if you are worrying about booking a full reading, you can, and it's not going to be on live. Do my man love me? No. It's not going to be on live. This is how you book it. Make sure y'all take a screenshot. I'm going to take one more free reading and then I'm going to get off of here. Will I get some D soon? Need a B. Call me. Need a B. Let's talk about your D situation. Need a B. Give me a call. Give me a call, Need a B. Call me. You got a free mini reading. Need a B. You got a free mini reading. Give me a call. Like right now. Don't call me. Don't call my ass tomorrow. Talking about I'm the one in front. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Give me a call right now. Here we go. What up? You...
Okay, I'm ready.
What's going on, Nita B? So you say you need a little D in your life.
I do.
What if I tell you already know the D?
You did it. You just told me I need to get out the house and find somebody.
The D that you... Well, I ain't talking about that's like for some ever D, but I'm talking about you can get some D today.
No,
why can't you talk to nobody? This is some oldie. Who was a guy that's bald head? He like y'all ain't never did nothing before.
I can't see nobody that's bald headed.
Brown skin bald head? Y'all ain't never did nothing before. He ain't a looker.
I can't even see myself doing that.
You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about? Yeah.
Good, no.
What? I'm trying to tell you. I said today. I didn't say forever. I know. I just saw him. I said he bald head. He ain't a looker. I knew he was. Girl, bye. Go to get some D today.
Okay. If it don't work out with this job, I'm tipped now, but I'm thinking about going to the company. I don't know if I should, though.
You should.
Okay.
Now, back to this neighbor. Why you don't want to do that?
Because he got some issues.
What issues he got?
He got some female issues, and we stay too close. Like
that has nothing to do with what we're doing tonight. Y'all be worrying about shit that do not concern you. Okay, that man has already let you know that you can get it. Not him. He already let you know subtly that you know what Janice say anytime, any place.
No, he hasn't. I swear.
He joking with you. You know the man like you a little bit.
Oh Lord, I didn't know it.
He do.
Can you get out? I'm a speakerphone, child.
Oh Lord. Hello?
Yeah, it's never been that type of vibe.
Yeah, okay, well, it's that type of vibe. If you wanted it, you can get it. Now, I'm going to say this and say that. You worried about the wrong stuff. I didn't say that was going to be your man. That's not that. I'm talking about if you wanted to get some D today, quick, like a hot and ready, like a Little Caesars $5 pizza when it was $5. That's where it would come from. But that's okay. If not, then go ahead and get out and find somebody and do what you need to do. But I'm just saying, the D is available. You worried about women problems. See, always gonna have women problems. It ain't got nothing to do with you. Cause you ain't trying to be his woman. You understand what I'm saying?
True.
Okay? But I'm gonna say that to say this. How would I know about him? I said you ain't never did nothing with him before. But if you wanted to, you said you was trying to avoid that. Tell me, I don't know who it is. You went Ray Charles on my ass. I can't see that. She went Ray Charles on me, didn't she, y'all? I don't see that.
Man, I see it. That's a
note. Yeah, okay. Well, I just told you where to get the D from. What else you want to know? You got one more question.
Okay, I did have one more.
What up?
Do I need to get checked out again ever for breast cancer?
You need to get checked out again for breast cancer?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Have you been feeling a mass?
No, but I've been getting checked since I've been 21.
Yeah, I want you, it's going to be something small. It's going to be a benign tumor, but I want you to get checked just to get checked. There's something irregular. Under your left breast, like kind of like in here. Like, I don't know if you still watching me online.
No, I'm not. But
okay, it's something. I want you to take your right hand and put it all the way across, almost like where you're down by your armpit, and start pressing. You're going to feel something a little small. Go ahead and get it checked out.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've felt that before.
Okay.
I'm going to run to the family. I just want to make
you sure. Said you felt that before?
Yeah, but I've had a reduction, so I don't know which tissues
is
what tissue.
No, but I told you go get it checked. That's what I'm saying. I can feel it. So when I told you, okay. I saw and I can feel it. It's right up under here. It's a little something. It's nothing really major, but it's a little something. I want you to get it checked.
Okay.
Okay. Anything else?
Nope, that's about it.
All right, go and call that man. Bye. Y'all give it up for her and her next door neighbor, honey. She be playing. Come on, y'all. You say, baby, I be knowing. Okay, so here's the deal about general readings. Let me tell you how I work. That's a good question. Yeah, give it up for her, y'all. Will I go to Nigeria? Myself, me and mine, I almost want to give you a free mini reading just to be nosy and be in your damn business. But, ooh. Friend, are you going to Nigeria for a man? Are you going to Nigeria for a man? Let me know right now. Because if so, we about to do a mini reading on your ass. She said, where's the D? And you told her. Yes, thank you. My eyebrows are microbladed, y'all. My eyebrows been like this since 2000. You said you want to go to Nigeria for a minute? Call me. We just want to be in your business at this point. See you later, Missy. Let me make this call, but I'm nervous. You'll be fine. Be quiet. Call me, girl. The one that's going to Nigeria, give me a call. Let me get you a free mini reading just so we can be in your business. How do my readings work? So you ask me clear and direct questions. If I see something else, just how these people been asking me, you ask me questions. As far as the general reading, I feel like people do general readings when they're using cards and stuff like that. I don't do that. As you see, I don't have no cards. I don't have no nothing. This is just God-given. I have visions. I'm a super empath. I'm a medium. I like to say extra large. I'm a psychic. I do communicate with spirits. Do not be trying to call your ancestors to come and play with me. I don't have time for that. I do also see demons on people as well. All right, here we go.
Friend.
All right, friend. Who is this?
Chiquita.
Is you me, mine, me, theirs? All that shit. Okay, why are you going to Nigeria?
Say what now?
Why is your ass going to Nigeria?
Because I want to go, friend. I want
to
go.
Are you trying to find somebody? You trying to find a husband in Nigeria because you watching these TikToks?
Oh, yeah. Well, I talk to my friend. I be talking to him on the phone.
Listen, first of all, you need to delete WhatsApp off your damn... Yeah. Yes, I accept donations. Friend. Delete WhatsApp off your phone. It's the devil. And stop and listen.
What?
Listen. I understand you've been watching these TikToks and you've been inspired and you're like, I'm going to go over there because I see these black women over there and they getting these Nigerian men. Let me tell you something. Save your money. Now, you want to go over there and you just want to have vacation and that's the vacation. Save your money. These men will say anything that you want to. Stop. How you going to be in Nigeria and the women in Nigeria don't even want your ass? And then how y'all going over there? I'm not doing this today.
Damn it,
Frank. I said she be watching this shit on TikTok and then got inspired. Like, I'm going to do that too. And I'm going to be talking to him and all this stuff. And girl, get off. Let me tell you something. I'm going to tell you what's about to happen. You ready? Carry the five at the six. I'm about to tell you right now. You're going to take your rabbit ass over there. Huh? You're going to find, because you've been talking to one. You actually been talking to two. But it's one of them that really is very attentive to you. The other one is kind of hit or miss. Okay? This one you've been talking to, he attentive to you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Ask about your day and how are you doing and, oh, I was thinking about you.
Yes, bullshit, ain't it? Some bullshit, ain't it?
Making you feel good. Calling you, keeping up with the time zones and everything.
Uh-huh.
Don't play with me, sis. Don't play with me. You're going to go over there. Okay? He gonna steal your goddamn, you trying to go there and see his ass. I should throw this phone, but I ain't got enough. I won't get another one until Monday. He gonna go over there. He gonna take money. If you, first of all, he's gonna tell you that you have to get your money, switched over or whatever, right? Uh-huh. And he's going to steal money. Listen, let me tell you something. He's gonna get you over there, and he's gonna steal money from you.
Oh, well, we ain't going.
No, you still gonna go, because ain't nobody. No, you saying that shit for online. You going.
Oh, hell no, we ain't going. No.
You ain't the only chick he's talking to like this either.
Friend, I need to delete that shit off my phone.
Yes, you need to delete it off your phone. What is you doing?
I just like the conversation. I'll be bored.
Okay, so if you want some conversations, then you just get on a regular date nap. Let somebody in your area BS you. You don't need nobody overseas, and then your rabbit ass setting alarms and stuff, waking up at certain times to talk to him. I should come through this phone on you.
I like it. I love it.
I hate you. I hate you.
I love it.
I hate you.
That's all right, ain't it?
Listen,
I try, Brid. You get so tired of not having somebody. And I've been with myself. I get tired of it.
I understand that. I date him. I know she ain't setting an alarm. Friend, do you try to talk to him during his daytime as well?
During his daytime, friend, because I've been in bed at my day, at this time.
Exactly. Listen, you can find somebody to BS you. If you want to do that, then go ahead and get you a pen pal in prison. You want somebody to BS you?
That's with friends.
It's some fine ones in prison.
Friend, I ain't never been married. Would I ever get married, friend? Would I ever?
You will get married. You will get married.
Oh, God,
hold on, but wait, pipe down. Let me say this to say that.
What?
Your husband ain't gonna have as much as you do. Listen, your husband ain't gonna have as much as you do, but he's gonna be a hard worker. See, that's another problem you've been running into.
Oh my God.
But he gonna be a hard worker.
Okay.
And he gonna love you. He gonna be a little younger than you.
Fuck good.
Okay, I'm about to hang up on her ass. You know we out here on this damn TikTok. Get off my damn, you know what?
My bad.
Get your ass. We on the damn tick of the top. What is wrong with you? Yes. Your husband gonna be dumber than a box of rocks, but he gonna love you, and he gonna put you to sleep.
He gonna be dumber than a box of rocks.
But whatever you tell him to do, let me tell you something about you. See, let me tell you why you ain't worried about no man, because you really don't need no man. You don't need one financially.
Oh my God, I just wish you was.
Yeah, but you don't. Tell me I'm lying, though. Tell me I'm lying. I know you don't need a man financially. I know you do. I know you don't. So that's what I'm saying. That's why you don't mind playing these games. And see, it make you feel better playing these games with somebody in Nigeria than it do with playing these games with somebody locally. Because you ain't going to have nobody make no fool out of you. Come on.
One damn thing
about
it, they can't get to me.
Huh? Yeah. You ain't going to have nobody make no fool out of you. Nah. So you ain't even gonna play. Ain't nobody in your hometown ain't gonna play these games with you. So you doing this little silly stuff because you missed the attention. Now you want to get somebody, go and get you a prison boo. You understand me? I ain't saying marry him or.
I got an ex in prison.
No. I ain't say the ex in prison. I said a prison boo. If you want somebody just to talk to you and say sweet nothings, then get you a prison boo. They real good at that. And the prison boo you get ain't even gonna ask you for nothing. He just gonna be happy and he gonna be fine too. Gonna get your name tattooed on him and everything. It don't matter. It's about 10 other chicks' name tattooed. He even got cover ups. But it's gonna make you feel special. But this Nigeria thing is a no, ma'am. Is a no.
Oh Lord.
Okay.
That's all right, friend. That's all right.
Somebody said, tell her I got a brother that will talk to her all day. Okay, Shay's abundance. Get the hell off my friend. I'm about to hang up on your ass. And I'm about to, and Shay's abundance, I'm about to cuss her out. But listen, real talk. It is somebody for you. Let me be honest with you. Let me keep it 100 with you, though. But I knew you was going to be good fun. Listen, there is somebody for you. He actually is in, how far is Alabama from Mississippi?
About 700 miles. Depends on what part.
But he actually owns a farm in Alabama.
Oh, shit, man.
Yeah. Yeah, and he got some money. So, listen, he got some money. You hear me?
I need you
to get on. He is on Bumble.
Who?
Bumble. It's a dating website for professional people. He's on Bumble.
Bumble
with a B. B. B is in boy. Bumble. Get on Bumble. For real. Get on Bumble tonight and stop messing with them dudes on WhatsApp. Now get off my damn phone. Y'all give it up for her. You are my African queen. Get your ass off my phone. Woo! That was a good one, y'all. Okay. Girl of my dreams. Oh, my God. So people were asking me, listen, that was for her, Josie. Did anybody say nothing about your ass? Okay, she talking about, now let me get on Bumble. I'm taking notes, Lord. You say, what's my Cash App? That's my Cash App, y'all. Y'all are funny. Has someone done spell work on me? Yes, ma'am, and I can't get it off, so don't ask me. Y'all talking about downloads, Bumble. Good luck, friend. That's my Cash App, y'all. You have to use the, it is two federal prisons in Mississippi. Friend say, what does my kids think about my spiritually ratchet lives? My kids don't watch my spiritually ratchet lives. Here's the deal. I've been a fool all their life. I used to be a stand-up comedian for 10 years. So nothing I say, my kids don't even, like, this don't even faze them because they grew up, they were in elementary and middle school and their mother was this whole, I was a professional stand-up comedian. I traveled. So this, none of this fazes them. Like, their friends would be all like, oh my God, I saw your mother's YouTube. They'd be like, all right. No. So this don't faze them. No, I've been a fool their whole damn life. You said, wow, I knew it. Thank you, friend. You're welcome. Why did I stop being a stand-up comedian? To be honest with you, because I can make more money getting on here on TikTok from the comfort of my own home and talking crazy to y'all. That's why. It was just time to stop being a comedian. I was over it. I did it for 10 years. Thank you. That's it. That's all. Even when I was doing my story times, before I started sharing my gift with y'all, even when I was doing story time, all right, hold on, y'all, we got some Cash App stuff. Marilyn, you next. Even when I was doing my story times or whatever, and people would do tips or buy my books. Uh-uh. Oh, okay. Okay, so Marilyn, you want yours private. We will do yours private. All right, Miss Steele, here you go. The lady who said she sent hers, I need your phone number. Balanish, I need your phone number, okay? You need to text me your phone number, honey bun. You didn't put your phone number in the comments. So, Miss Steele, you got a question. Say, will my future husband have a good career? Damn, so you want to know about your future husband and the career. My books are in my link tree. Yes, my books. I got books on Amazon. They're in my link tree as well. My books are a hoot. Will my future husband have a good career? Yes, your future husband will have a good career. Your future husband is actually going to be highly educated. And he's going to have a career in corporate America. Is it Balanish? Do you want yours on live? Balanish, do you want yours on live? Yes or no, friend? I'm waiting for you to be in the comments. Balanish, do you want me to call you now or do you want a private reading? Oh, she said sure. All right, y'all. We got a full reading coming up. Let's get it. Let's go. Can I win Andrew's heart again? No. Y'all know how I feel about that. You're more than welcome, honey bun.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing better. How are you?
I'm awesome. I see you local, too. We might have to meet up or something one day. I'm in downtown Dallas. But anyway, come on. Yes. Oh, girl, if I come out there, I might have to spend the night. I used to live in Louisville. What you want to know?
So I want to know if me and my husband are going to work out.
Okay. You are. That's a lot, honey. You are going to work out in the long run, but you all are going to separate at least twice.
Wow.
Where is he at now?
We still live together now, but he's leaving next week, like Monday, to go to the Army.
Okay. Right. So you all are going to have to separate. Yeah, you're going to separate twice, but that's not a bad thing. So this will be the first separation.
Okay.
Okay, and then there's another one coming. So he might come back, and then, or either he's going to get deployed somewhere, and that would be the second one.
Okay.
Okay? So, I don't know who this is talking about. It says I got to accept their payment. I don't see it yet. Okay, what else you want to know?
My mouth doing too much.
It's your what?
My mouth, like.
The what you say to your husband?
Yeah.
Yeah, you a little off the chain. That's not even in his nature. He not even used to no shit like that.
No, he not. He Nigerian.
I could tell by your name was off. You got 6'7", but that ain't even about being by Nigerian. I know it's some Nigerians that still, but he's not even used to that. Like, his mom is not like that or anything. He really went out on a limb to marry you.
Okay.
And he went against the advice of some of his elders.
Okay.
Don't prove him wrong. Still, I answered your question. I say he gonna be in corporate America.
Yep.
Hold on one second. No. Hold on. Not you, boo-boo. Still, I know what you're talking about. Lord Dash, I got your question. I said your husband's going to be in corporate America. He's actually going to be highly educated. All right, friend, back to you. So I need you to kind of pipe down on all that shit you be talking about. Because let me tell you this. Your husband loves you and things of that nature. Oh, that's you, Colleen Steele? Okay, bye. Okay, I know who it was. Never mind, Lord Dash. I thought you was somebody else. All right, look, let me get back to my reading. My fault, y'all. So there is going to be somebody that approaches him when he's in basic training. And she's going to have a calmer nature than you do. I need you to pipe down.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I need you to do that.
Okay.
What else?
I was just on that.
What about babies?
I got my tooth cut. I want babies, but I don't think this is a situation for me to be trying to get a tubal reversal and bring a baby into it. Not right now.
No, not right now. Not right now. But once you all end up moving when he's stationed, that conversation is going to come up.
Okay.
Okay, so I need you to start thinking about that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I knew babies was a topic with y'all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was a topic because I have kids and he don't have kids.
Right.
And we're married, so that was.
And he needs the offspring, and he loves your children, but he needs the offspring.
I was open to, but the situation where we going with this miscommunication, and I feel like I'm hurt, but my words, they not coming out right, like. Is being attacked, so he's just feeling the attack part. He's not feeling seeing where
I want you to try and write it in a letter.
Okay.
He's not used to your demeanor. It's not so much your words as demeanor and how it's coming out. See, you a fighter. You're a little scrappy.
Mm-hmm.
Right, and you had to be before.
Yes.
And you don't have to do that with him. And that's something that you need to work through. And it's part of the separation. I want you, once he does leave, I want you to go ahead and start working on you as well. Because you don't have to do that with him. And he really doesn't know how to tell you that. You know it in your spirit. But he's trying to find a productive way to tell you that.
Okay.
Okay? You don't have to do that. He ain't the last one. So this separation, also, I want you to use this separation for you to get to know each other all over again. Because all you're going to have to do is communicate. Okay?
Yeah.
I want you to take it back to the beginning. He loves you and you love him. And he loves those kids. Please don't make this man out to be no fool.
I don't want to do that. I love my husband.
I know you do, friend. I just need you to understand that he's not like the father of them kids. You don't have to do that. Okay?
Yeah.
It's all right. It's okay. I want you to spend the rest of you. Will he leave next week?
Yeah.
Okay. I want you to spend the rest of this time you have and just in silence, but being around him. I don't care if it's cuddling or hugging or just kissing him. You need to show him all the affection that you can. And don't start talking about, don't you get to run in your damn mouth, because it's going to come off and it's going to mess up the mood. Okay? Okay? One of his love languages is touch.
Okay.
And I need you to activate that.
Okay.
Okay? And you are going to get pregnant again. You hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
You're going to have a little boy.
Oh, really?
Yes. That's what he wants more than anything. So that's going to happen after you all get stationed. And when you have that talk, I want you to go ahead and agree. That's one of the reasons why, yeah, the tubal reversal, that's another reason why he's doing what he's doing. So the Army can pay for it. What else?
That's it.
Okay, go ahead and love on your husband right now. You hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, friend. You can, yes. We'll meet up before you move, okay?
Okay.
All right, bye. Y'all give it up for her. Thank y'all for doing that on there. Yes, come on. That was a good one. Yes, okay. We got friends say she'll do hers on live. Yes, y'all give it up for her. Yeah, y'all don't be on, y'all be talking about, I'm on here crying, looking asses. All right, that was a Balinese. Y'all, let's pray and send good energy her way. That was beautiful. All right, Marilyn say, okay, so Keidra, I see you on a private reading. No problem. I'll contact you after this live. Y'all don't be on here crying. Crazy tales. Don't be on here crying. Okay, y'all, the only reason I answered the question about her baby. Now, who is calling me? Oh, that's her. I don't know who. Come on. Hold on, friend. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, oh, shit. What you want to know? Hold on. Let me get a snack. Do I still got eating hours? I still got 30 minutes. Hold on. Well, that's what we not about to do. Okay. We got fruit snack. What happened?
I want to know about my finances. Right now I'm working a job, but it's not bringing in enough. Will I have to supplement it?
No, not supplement it. You have to find a whole new career path.
Ooh, okay.
You have to find a whole new career path because this ain't working for you. And the thing about it, the new career, they're going to train you. I know you ain't trying to go back to school or nothing like that. Thank you, friend. I know you ain't trying to go back to school or anything like that. But they're going to, yeah, you're going to have to change a whole new career because that just ain't working. Even if you was to switch jobs, it wouldn't work.
Okay.
What else you want to know?
My personal life. I really don't have one right now. So where is that going?
Okay. The reason why is your frequency is low.
Okay.
You ain't feeling your job. You ain't feeling your money. Or whatever. So I know you would like the company of somebody else to kind of take your thoughts of, from what's going on with that. But you ain't even got enough energy to see who is somebody wants you.
Okay.
And it's somebody that wants you. What kind of work you do?
I am a customer service / administrator.
Was the company, is the company like industrial?
Yeah, it's a factory, but I work in the other side. I'm not in the...
Their uniform's gray or blue?
They wear blue, yeah.
They wear blue. Yep. It's a dude in the factory that like you.
Oh, Jesus.
Yep. I be knowing. He brown skin with a full beard.
Okay.
Yep. He brown, he got his hair cut. It's not like super low. He got like the little waves or whatever. And he's about in his 40s. You know what I'm talking about?
I think I know who you're talking about.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep.
But I actually haven't been working there very long.
I don't give a damn about none of that. He wants you. He kind of medium build. Yeah. like old brown chocolate teddy bear. Okay, turn off the light, looking ass. Yeah. Wow. I need you when you going to work. I need you to have a little pep in your step.
Okay.
You hear me?
Yeah.
I need you to get cute all next week.
Okay.
See, he's been passing by, trying to get you to notice him, but you keep your head down, literally and figuratively, because your money situation is messed up.
Yeah.
And you really don't pay attention to your surroundings. He's a quiet man and really don't want too many people in his business. So that's why he ain't really asked nobody about you. But he's trying to get your attention. So I want you to go to work. Now, the money may not be where you need it to be, but I need you to go to work next week and be looking out for that.
Okay.
Y'all gonna hang out and have a good time.
Okay.
That's what you need. What else you wanna know?
My younger son is going to college. He started college, but right now finances are not there. I just want
to
know.
So they're going to be there. So I'm going to say this to say that. They're going to be there. I need you to contact the financial aid office and see if there's any other scholarship opportunities that he can partake in. And I also need y'all to look online for scholarships. There's actually a local scholarship that he can get, and GPA doesn't matter. I need you to do that. I need you and your son to work together on this one. Your son is going to graduate from college. You hear me?
Yeah.
That man I'm talking about, he's willing to help you.
Okay.
Yeah, he like you. Mm-hmm. What else?
What do you see?
I see you having a good time. I see this man stepping in and helping out, with, especially with that younger son. Okay? I see in this being about something. Even if you leave your job, that's not going to change. The relationship that you're going to have with this man is not going to change. You do need to learn something totally different.
Okay.
You do need to do something else. Yes, ma'am. Y'all gonna be all right. What else?
I actually started a little small business on the side during the pandemic. Just want to know where that's going.
First of all, change the verbiage. It's not a little small business. I want you to say this is a $1 million business. I don't care if you ain't got two pennies to rub together. I want you to say it's a $1 million business. Once you do start this new career and have this new man and start feeling better about yourself, you will start to find time to dedicate towards this business and your creativity will start flowing again. The reason why your business has been in a stunt, because you've been in a stunt.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's all right. You need a little time out and you need a little D.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What else?
I don't know. There is somebody that an ex that has been trying.
Hell nah. That's a no. What else?
Those are just the major things. The major things going on right now.
Mhm. You got a light colored dress or a white dress you can wear to work? Like a summer dress?
I have a summer dress.
Yeah, okay. Wear that to work. It's going to look real nice and get your skin.
Okay.
Make sure you grease up your shoulders and shit. Okay.
Okay.
Go in there looking like a new penny. Friend, you're going to be all right. Let me know when y'all hang out. I like confirmation too, y'all. So let me know when y'all hang out, okay?
Okay.
All right. That's it. You ain't got no more questions?
Nothing else. Not unless you see anything else. No,
I don't see nothing but you having a good time getting you some, friend.
Okay.
All right. You have a great day. You have a great week at work tomorrow. Next week. I want you to be cute every day of the week and walk in there with your head up, held up high.
Okay.
All right, friend. Y'all give it up for her. Woo! Baby, she going to get her a man at work. Okay? Everybody need a man at work. That was it, baby. She said, I know who you're talking about because I be knowing. Now, some of y'all don't need some. Some of y'all heifers don't need it. Who else want they reading live? I'm going to do one more live reading. That was a good one. Give it up for her. So, Marcella, you want yours live? Yes or no? You said, I got an apartment downtown. You said I was going to get. Why? Because I be knowing. Marcella, you want yours live? Call me. Stella, give me a call. Because I be knowing. I be telling y'all that shit. Okay, this you? Give me a call, Marcella. Come on. Call me. Y'all, this is how y'all book a reading with me. Y'all can have a private reading. I have openings on Friday and Saturday. So you can either go to my Linktree and book your appointment, or you can go ahead and send the $25 via Cash App and make sure you put your phone number. Y'all, this is my... I don't do manifest class every Sunday. Nope, I won't do another one. It won't be enough time soon. What's up, friend? You ready?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Come on now. What you want to know?
To begin with, I would like to know how my health will be
in the future. Like, how is it going? Because
I do have an illness that I deal with a lot.
You got sickle cell? Yes. Now, how did I know that? Baby, hold on. No, I know your TikTok. I never went to your TikTok. I don't do that.
But yes, I do have sickle cell.
So listen, let me tell y'all something. Well, I've been sitting here. I haven't went on her TikTok because I've been talking to y'all since she sent this Cash App. Y'all been watching me, right? I haven't been to her TikTok. I don't follow her or anything like that. Y'all would have saw me go. I would have to leave my live and go look her up. I be knowing. Come on. What else, friend?
Trust
you. Wow. Well, I guess
I
want to
know how that will be, because that's been hindering me a lot of things as far as, like, my career and everything. Like, I'm afraid to leave the house at this point.
No, I don't need to. I know you're afraid to leave, like, if you would catch something
because
you're compromised autoimmune system.
Yeah, I've caught COVID a couple times. Yeah. I had pneumonia, like, 5-4 times last year. So, I've had everything that's been popular. So, I'm afraid to catch the next thing.
Okay. I got you. Definitely be cautious. I'm not saying go out here and just be a night on the town, because what you're doing is what you need to do that. I'm not talking about going here and just kick your heels up, but I do need you to do research about the places you go. You do need to go get out and do something.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
You do, but please continue to be cautious. I don't give a damn if you wear gloves out. You need to, because monkeypox is real. Look, I'm itching talking about the shit. But just be cautious about who it is. Are you in any support groups?
No, I'm not.
I need you to join one.
Okay.
And I'm not saying that because, you need support. I need you to join one because you're going to meet somebody else with sickle cell. You're going to meet a guy. And y'all can be cautious together. It's going to turn into just like a friendship thing. You all are going to bond over what you have. But it could be, I'm going to say this, it could be something more if you want it to be. But if nothing else, you'll have a friend. A good one. Somebody that's there for you, okay?
Okay.
Because a lot of people have let you down that you want to be your friend because they don't know how to deal with what you got going. And it's easier just to walk away from you than to, ask how they can be of assistance.
True.
Mm-hmm. What else you want to know?
I did ask in the chat. Have I recently met my future boyfriend?
Nope. You need to join a group. Nope. You are going to meet him. Check out on Facebook and this app called Meetup about, young people living with sickle cell or people of color.
I really don't
want to
meet nobody that has sickle cell.
I mean, you may not want to, but this is somebody. So, here's the deal. Let me be honest with you. And you done had this happen before. What you got going on runs men off.
Right.
It's a lot to deal with. I understand you're like, well, I don't want nobody that's sick like me. It's not about meeting. The person you meet is not going to have as many afflictions as you have had.
Right.
But they understand. See, that's the problem is you don't have nobody that's understanding. They say they understand. They say they're going to work with you until you get sick. And then it's a different story. Then they say, this is too much for me to handle. Like I said, this situation that you're going into can be something more if you want it to be. If you don't, it's don't. Then no.
Right. Okay. Do you see me moving out of Miami?
Not no time soon. No, ma'am. What else?
also, I guess you might be studying to find support group for those, unless they will like some figure out my career.
What about your girl? Okay, so what do you want? So when you ask me, I ask people to ask me detailed and direct questions. Because so sometimes when you don't know, go, what is it?
At this point, I can admit that I've kind of lost myself and my passion over the years. I kind of hit life early and take care of my family really young.
So what is it that you want to do?
So it's like, I'm stuck at trying to find.
What is it that you want to do?
I was in school for education.
So with that being said, I mean, if you were to go to school, you can't teach. I mean, you could teach virtually, but you're not going to put yourself in where you're teaching in front of a classroom of children or even adults in a big group.
My passion was the medical field, but obviously that's...
Yeah, so, right. So I need you to figure out how you can do your passion, but do it without exposing yourself.
Right.
Yep. I want you to spend some time this weekend figuring that out.
Okay.
And I need you to start living. Don't let sickle cell be the end all. I need you to start living, even if it's just in your house. I need you to start thinking differently about how you approach things, okay?
Right.
What other questions you have?
I did recently stop being friends with my best friend like 12 years. Will she come back? What way? Friends of the past come back?
Nah. Like, I'm going to say this. Sorry, y'all. I got the TV on the thing. You don't even want them. So the thing about that is you really don't even want them or need them to come back. I need you to make new friends. I wouldn't even want folks like that to come back in my life.
All right.
Like, I wouldn't even want that.
That's understandable.
Yep. What else?
You said you could sense demons or spell work or something.
Ain't nobody did no spell work on your ass.
Okay.
Ain't nothing on you but you. Ain't nothing on you but you, friend. Ain't nobody did nothing on you.
Okay.
So they said teach English to people in other countries through a virtual company. That's good. Yeah, ain't nobody did nothing on to you but you. You're the only thing that's holding you back.
Okay.
Yeah, I need you to raise your energy level because you just like, okay. It's just like, womp womp.
I said it kind of crying a little bit, but...
Why? Why are you crying?
No, because when you were talking about the underneath, the understanding and stuff, because I live in Miami by myself, no family. So, trying to find support and everything, it's kind of hard.
Right, I told you to find a support group.
So, yeah, I'm going to go about that, seriously.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you got us. You got a whole new TikTok family, girl. Hashtag, we be knowing.
Thank you.
You hear me? Get online tonight and find you a group. You understand me? For real. Meetup is a good starting place. Get on Meetup first and then go to Facebook. You are going to find a group of people within the next 45 days. You are not alone, okay?
Okay.
You're just new to the place. What else?
Also, I guess I want to be with my family. It's going to be okay. Because like I said, I became the breadwinner at like 15,
16. And now I'm not with them. So your family is going to be just fine. See, here's the deal. I understand you became the breadwinner. But at some point, you became a crutch. So you got to let them fly. Okay?
Cool.
Huh? Did that did something for you?
Yeah. I got three kids. Don't have any.
Yeah. Yeah, at some point you gotta let them fly. On their own. Okay?
Right.
Yeah. You gonna be okay, girl. Get on there and find it.
Okay. No, I feel great.
Okay, yeah. Don't cry. Listen, you are doing a lot. You are doing more than other people expected you to do. So I want you to be proud of yourself, and I want you to know that there is a community out there waiting for you that's going to not only love on you, but love on your babies. I need you to know that.
Oh, I don't have any kids right now.
Wait, who got the three kids?
No, I said I feel like I have three kids. kids, but I don't have.
Oh, okay. I was all like, wait, because I was like, shit, you out there with the kids? Okay. I was all like, love on you and the babies. Well, they going to love on you.
Yeah. I would like a baby in the future.
Okay.
But yeah, not now. Okay.
All right. Your family all right? I need you to be all right.
All right. Thank you.
For real. All right, friend. Well, I'll be on live, and you can come and jump in, and we got you. We got some people in here that's in your area, too, okay?
Okay.
If you need some support. All right, y'all. Everybody that's in Miami, listen. Listen, everybody that's in Miami, y'all put your comment on there. Y'all friend each other, and y'all go ahead and do that. Yes, hugs. Yes, yes, yes. Friend said, thank you for your manifestation class. It's been a major blessing. So, friend, if you in Florida, y'all, make sure y'all go in there so y'all can go ahead and, you said he is on his way. I'm going to take your advice. Oh, you're welcome, friend. Oh, old girl from earlier said she about to. Remember our first call, baby, if you wasn't on her. What is her name? I think it's, damn, what was her name? Baby, if the one that just did the reading, can you come back in here and post your username? There's people in here in Florida. I don't know her name. Thundercat said, oh, boy is on the way. Thundercat, the first reading we did, she said he on the way. She gonna go ahead and give it up. So real quick, y'all, it's Celia, but we don't know her username. No, not the girl with the neighbor, the one that's been celibate for 37 years. Taylor, this is your question. What's up with this young guy I met? Baby. That young guy you met, Taylor. First of all, I'm going to say this and say that. That young guy you met is not the one. Okay? However, he is the one for this weekend. All right? There she go. Finding peace. There she is, y'all. That's her. Go friend her, y'all. Finding peace. Friend said, oh, you looked on my thing. Now, I ain't going to lie, y'all. My feelings was a little hurt. Y'all, there she go. Finding peace. She's in the comments, y'all. Go friend her. My feelings was a little hurt when she was like, oh, well, you looked on my profile. Me? Did y'all feel that? I was like, hey, I would never. I don't play with my gift like that. And that ain't the first time I done called out somebody's illness. Hell, I'm telling people where the lumps in their breast at. I was just like, oh, no, it's okay, friend. I know, but I was just like, no, I don't do stuff like that. I be feeling it. I be knowing. All right. Yeah, I was like, so I'm eating fruit snacks. Why is my daughter acting out? That sound like you need to book a reading. All right, y'all. So, you said, yes, you did. Right, I told you where the lump on your damn breast was. Taylor, where you at, girl? Taylor, where you at? I'm about to get off this live. We done had a good time. I might go to the movies. Can I tell you where your man at? For a fee? What? Taylor, that young man you done met, he gonna rock your world. That's about it. That's it. That's all. He gonna rock your world. And yeah, he already did. Yeah. That's it. He a good. That's what he good for. He a good time. And so, but I need you to have a good time. Okay? Okay. All right, y'all. Take a screenshot. I think I'm about to go to the movies. Oh, if y'all want to know about my hair, this ain't my hair. Y'all know that. Don't worry about him being so young. It don't even matter. Don't worry about that. You said, what is Justice hiding from me? I cashed at you. You ain't cashed at me, baby. Hold on. Let me go back to my cash app. I done answered all the Cash App questions I had. I look like I done answered it. Hold on. You might have just sent it. And it better not be no damn dollar. I'm going to lose it. Hold on. I swear to God. Okay. You say, what is Justice hiding from you? What's my wig name? I do free yes or no's, but I'm about to go. So before I answer this question for Monica, she said, what is Justice hiding from you? Justice hiding a whole bunch of shit from you. Justice hiding a whole nother relationship from you. If you want to book a reading for tomorrow or Saturday, this is how you do it. You can Cash App the $25 with your phone number. I will contact you within 24 hours to go ahead and get your reading time. Or you can just go to my Linktree and book your own damn reading. And we can do it like that. Okay? If you want to know... No, don't wait. Check Cash App. I'm sick of y'all. I'll check Cash App one more time. If you want more information about where my hair come from, it's delicious and nutritious. Y'all, I'm going to do this real quick for y'all. I shouldn't do it, but this is delicious and nutritious. Okay? That's the hair. She's giving. I had her pent up. She's giving. All right? If y'all want information about the hair, go ahead and text the word hair to that number. Take a screenshot. And then I'm going to check my Cash App one more time, answer these questions, and I'm out. Text the wedded. I just got her. She looking a little dry? She looking a little dry? If I wet it, it's probably looking like that because I just took it out this clip. If I wet her, I'm going to put a little mousse through her. If I wet her, it's really going to be something different. Okay? If I put some mousse through her, it's really going to get stupid. I might put a little spritz on her, a little ra-ta-ta-ta, but baby, she's giving. Okay? Yeah, I just got her, so I don't know about wetting it just yet. If you want information on the BAW, on Big Ass Workout, real quick, y'all, before I check my Cash App, I am holding a FUPA challenge. So we are doing a weight loss challenge. You can sign up until next Monday. It's a $500 one prize winner. $500 at the end of September or whatever. You get to work out with us virtually. We have workouts 5 days a week. If you want more about the Find Your Box Challenge, then you can just text that number and put weight loss or you want to work out. And I'll send you the link on how you can join the Find Your Box Challenge. We give you a customized intermittent fasting schedule. We're going to explore keto. Keto. Text that. You say, how many questions can you ask during your reading? You got 10 minutes. You can ask me whatever hell you want to ask me. I don't have a limit on questions. You just got a time limit. It's 10 minutes. Okay? All right. So that's how we do that. So if you need the information on the hair, the weight loss, the readings, and you don't know how to book it or whatever, you're more than welcome. This is how you do it. You can just text me the number or you can do a Cash App. I will do more manifestation classes, but I'm going to just do one class. It's called a Super Saturday class. I'm going to do one Super Saturday class. I don't know when I'm going to do it, so give me a minute. I've been doing manifestation classes, and y'all hoes be missing out. So I'm a super manifester. That's what I do. Or whatever. I manifest what I want, when I want it, how I want it. Period. I manifest people, places, and things. You hear me? All right. What else? Okay. All right. Let's go. Let's check this Cash App. Justice is high in the life from you. Justice is holding high in a whole nother relationship. I'm going to tell you that right now. Oh, now y'all hoes want to send all these questions. No, don't send me another Cash App unless it's for a reading. So that's what Justice is hiding, friend. I need you to go through Justice shit. Yes, your date will go well. Dinesha, there go my friend. Yes, Dinesha, the man is in a relationship. Now, let me tell you about the relationship. Dinesha, you ready? You ready? Not I hate it here. Shut up, girl. Let me tell you about the Dinesha, where you at? Let me tell you about this relationship. He's in a relationship, but the relationship is at the tail end, okay? This is the tail end of that relationship. The relationship will be over, but I need you to hold on. Yes, he's in a relationship, because he's moving funny, ain't he? He moving funny. I know, because I be knowing. Yeah. His ass moving funny. And you trying to put your finger on it. Because he trying to tie up this relationship. You knew it because I knew it. You should have been asking me this shit. Yeah. But I need you to hold on, okay? He is a good dude. Do not worry. This is not something that he normally do. He's just trying to end it the right way. Y'all just happen to hit it off. Don't worry about it. Don't give up too soon, okay? Yeah, but he in a relationship. Uh-huh. And tell him just to come clean with it. Because, like, he lying for no reason. Okay. Who next? Not when will I start the leadership position? You need to book a reading, ma'am. All right. What is it? Quashonda. Ooh, she said, what's up with the guy I'm seeing? Okay. The guy you're seeing is an undercover bum. Most of his shit is borrowed. That's what's up with the guy you're seeing. Most of the stuff is borrowed. You hear me? Yeah, where you at, friend? Where you at? Quashonda, where you at? Yeah. Ain't nothing you see. The reality he painting for you is fiction. He's a bum. Okay? He trying to impress you to get in good with you so you can let your guards down. Yeah, where you at? You in these comments? Huh? He's a bum. Period. Now, what you do with that information is your business. But that's what that is. Yeah. I almost want you to call me. Friend, call me. Fuck it. Friend, you got 3 minutes. Call me. I just want to be nosy. Call me real quick. You got 3 minutes. Call me right now. You got 2 minutes, friend. Call me. I want to be nosy. Call me. Call me right now. We want to be nosy. Okay? We want to be in your business. Hurry, friend. I'm getting off in 2 minutes. Here she go. Oh, my God. Girl.
Hello.
What is really going on?
You sent me a wall.
An undercover bomb.
Oh, my God.
What did he tell you he got?
Just a single father trying to get custody of his kids is what he tells me.
Lying like a hoe. Girl, he ain't trying to get custody of no damn kids. See, that's a pity party. Girl, bye. If he wanted to see his kid. That's what I'm saying. I just said that. If he wanted to see his kids, he could see them. He's telling you that. He's an undercover bum.
Oh, my God.
You hear me? He lying, girl. If he wanted to see them kids, let me tell you something. Baby, if you could be a fly on the wall during them conversations, girl, listen, this woman is begging him to come get them kids.
Wow.
That's the storyline he get. So that way you don't question why you'll never see him with his children.
Gotcha.
Okay. This is deep. What else?
I'm supposed to go see him next month, so I'll just cancel that.
Cancel that shit. You can do bad all by yourself. Cancel that.
Okay.
Did he offer to pay for something?
No, he didn't.
Exactly, because he ain't got nothing. Because he ain't got shit. What else?
That makes sense.
And he got back child support. What else?
Yes, he does.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
What else, friend?
You just said a whole lot.
Let me tell you something. It's somebody that's about 3 miles. 3 miles. It's somebody within a 3 mile radius. If you at your place going to the right, it's somebody. What store do you go to a lot?
Walmart.
No, it's a smaller store than that. Like it's a corner store or something like that. Like a little neighborhood store.
Well, it's a neighborhood market.
Oh, it's a neighborhood market. Okay, it's a smaller one. You've seen a gentleman. You're going to see him again. You probably never paid attention to him. Y'all both go to the same store because he live in your area. He's a decent dude. He a lame, but he decent.
Dang, that's so crazy because the guy that I asked you about, I thought he was decent and he
kind of
lame.
No, he's lame because he's a liar. He's a bum. When I say a lame, I'm talking about this dude is like real plain. You probably wouldn't even notice him. He go to work. He ain't got no kids. He go to work. Okay. He mind his business. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like he go grocery shopping. He push his own car. Like his car ain't nothing loud and fancy. It's just, you know, whatever. But he is, you know, I'm talking about he that type of lame. No, you dealing with a bum. Okay, so what I want you to do when you go to Walmart, I just want you to keep looking around. Y'all gonna meet somewhere between the frozen food and frozen food aisles, and then right, like between you're gonna be coming out the frozen fruit aisle, and then it's like the meats are on the back wall or something. Like y'all gonna meet at that intersection.
Okay.
Well, okay.
I'm gonna keep my eyes open.
Keep your eyes open. Yeah. He normally not your type. But go ahead, friend. Okay, I'm about to go. I just want to tell you that. Now get off my damn phone. Bye. Okay, y'all. I'm gone. It's been real. Who need my information again? No, you're not gonna get your money back from them. She said, go get a tenant, sit out there. Y'all crazy as hell. Okay, don't come on here testing my gangster, talking about where am I in your skin, ho. Don't come on here testing my gangster. Don't do that in your skin. Okay? You said you sent a Cash App for a reading. Are you, Keedra? Y'all be on, where am I? Girl, fuck you. Where am I in your skin? In your house, crackhead. Stop playing with me. Okay? That's where you at. Don't play with me. So, somebody talking about they sent me a Cash App for a reading. Hold on. I just want to make sure before we get off of here. Don't come on here testing my damn gangster with that. Y'all done said, I'm sitting up here calling out sickness. I'm calling out mass and people's whatever, however, and you are. Where am I? What in the Carmen San Diego is this shit? Okay, Berthlyn, I need you to text me your number, okay? You welcome, baby. Berthlyn, that's a hell of a name. You need to text me your number. And if you don't, it's another one on here. I see BD. Okay, I see you, friend. If it's another one on here that didn't send me a number. That was from way back when. But it's okay. So if you don't send me a number, I'm just going to Cash App you. You fine, but don't play with me. I'm going to Cash App you $1 and tell you to text me your number, okay? So, y'all, if you forgot to put your number in the memos, make sure y'all text me y'all number. Or I'll just Cash App you $1 back and say, hey, you forgot your number, and text me. I will contact y'all either tonight or in the morning, and we will get your reading schedule. I want to say thank you for rocking with your girls. Shout out to everybody who did a live reading. I hope y'all was able to get something from that. Thank you for trusting me. And again, listen to the words that are coming out my mouth. I will never contact you to get a reading. I will never contact you on social media and say, oh, I want to do a reading for you. I don't even work like that. I don't pimp my gift, okay? So somebody is going to contact y'all. I ain't got to be psychic. The scammers, people have made pages that look like my page. If it ain't 100,000 followers, it ain't me. If that page ain't got over 100,000 followers, baby, it ain't me, okay? So please do not be bamboozled. When am I coming back to do live readings? I don't know. I may do some tomorrow night. It'll be before the end of the weekend. I try not to promise y'all a certain time because it's however my spirit is feeling. Yes, Katrina, you'll find a house. It's going to be a fixer-upper, but you're going to find one. So I will have private readings tomorrow and on Saturday. Please do not, if somebody contact y'all in your inbox, please report the page and block them. I will never contact you to ask you if I can do a reading for you. I don't do that, okay? All right, you know what? I always say, I love y'all because you love me back. If you want information about the hair, the readings, whatever you want information about, all you got to do is text that number, and I will get you the information that you need, okay? Yes, you should take the receptionist job, but I need you to keep looking. Will I get my car by Christmas? No, it's going to be by New Year's. Thank you so much for everything. Y'all Cash App this so y'all have it for future references. Is my new dude a life a keeper? Hell nah. Y'all, you're more than welcome. So I'm going to take my hand down in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hey, y'all, it's been real. I'm out. I see you when I see you. And bye.